Gran Turismo 7 absolutely nailed it with the 25th anniversary content recently. All of the unique stuff, the exclusive races, giving us more credits for the races, giving us some super combos, driving in the wet, driving really long 45-minute races online, giving us opportunities to answer quizzes, win engine swaps, win credits, win roulette tickets, the world finals as well, being able to kind of choose who we think is going to win and get some credits for that. Loads of amazing stuff, giving us the Red Bull X2019 car in exclusive delivery. But in this video, I'm going to let you know what Gran Turismo 7 should do next and why. Because I've taken a look at what's coming up, it leaves me a little bit worried. But first, a word from our sponsor, which is Aston Martin and Infinite Drive. Infinite Drive is an upcoming mobile racing game featuring, you guessed it, officially licensed Aston Martin and a load of other cars as well. There's going to be a free roam option. You're going to be able to join clubs. It's a racing platform where you can race, you can earn, you can collect cars. Looks really, really cool. Go check it out. There's a link in the description below. Thank you so much. Now, when it comes to Gran Turismo 7, what I appreciated so much with the 25th anniversary content was about the memories it created. Now, for me personally, that's doing the endurance race at Fuji online, a real test that they did at the World Finals in Monaco, and also doing that incredible race at Spa with the dynamic weather, having to guess a strategy, you know, wet track onto a dry track, intermediate onto dry tires. All that kind of stuff is incredible memories for me. When I looked at the daily race this week, I don't think those daily race online are going to create the same memories. And this applies to single player as well. We also want single player events that are going to be very memorable. That's what we all remember when we were growing up playing Gran Turismo in years gone by, you know, getting really attached to the cars, really attached to the specific events. And I'm showing you on screen here, this is what you can do even in Gran Turismo 7, just setting up your own custom offline lobby. You have all these settings. So I don't know why they consistently create events that are just so uninspiring. So I think what they need to do is do a real strategy to create memorable events offline and online. Now let me know in the comments, by the way, what are your most memorable moments in Gran Turismo 7 so far? It'll be really interesting to hear from both if you're playing single player and multiplayer. Now I do recognize that we don't want to drive every race in the wet. It's you know, it's just special occasions, but I think at the moment we can probably all agree that it's massively underutilized. And you can see here at the Nordschleife just how incredible the game is, and it really comes alive. And I was having a look at the world circuit map and trying to think of the locations where I really have those great memories in Gran Turismo 7. And for me, one of them was Suzuka, where at the beginning of the game, that's where I really test out cars, go there in crazy conditions, race at night. Same in the Red Bull Ring, you might remember those videos. Also, obviously, Daytona, that first week of the online daily races, daily race, see there racing against the best drivers in the world. Trial Mountain as well. I have memories there from watching the World Series events and kind of wanting to then drive that track myself as well. But for me, Gran Turismo is a game that it has a soul. That's what makes Gran Turismo different to Forza, makes it different to, you know, Project Cars. It's what makes it different to iRacing. And this is another point here. This is a real selling feature for Gran Turismo 7, this dynamic weather. Because, you know, we'll have a lot of people in the comments saying, well, Gran Turismo 7 is not a sim, Gran Turismo 7 is too arcadey. But ultimately, you can't do this in iRacing. You can't go on a wet track and test stuff like that. That's a real strength for Gran Turismo 7, and I wish they'd say more of it. So for me, that's the kind of strategy that I want them to have. The way I would do it is I would allow the community to curate races, add it to the showcase hub in the Gran Turismo 7 world map, and let people vote on them, let people drop that like button. And if you see a lot of people liking a race, it might be a really good race. Gran Turismo 7 can have a look at it, and maybe then they want to import it into the official, you know, daily races, or have it as an official offline event, maybe with some bonus credits. So those are my ideas. I really want to know what you think, because there was such hype around the 20th anniversary, and I want to see it continue. I want to see it continue. I will see you next time.